Warm-ups.
Warm-ups.
The warm-ups help you get in tune with your hands and help you get a better range of motion with your hands. The first thing I like to do is take one hand, take your other hand and grab it right around the thumb, move up slowly. This hand grabs here while this hand grabs here. Spring all the way up and through. And as you come around, bring this hand up and through also. So what you're doing is each hand is massaging the other, just like this. Back and forth. Also, if it's cold out, this is a good way to warm up your hands before some type of performance. A very simple thing is just making a fist and then extending your hands out. This also loosens up your hands very well. And these are very simple exercises, but if you do them every day, you'll be in better touch with your hands. Also, another one, putting your hands together, relaxing one side, and pushing with the other. Back and forth. Every day, back and forth. Now, the next warm-up is what I call the crossovers, where you're crossing your fingers over. What we're doing is crossing our second finger over our first and third finger over the fourth. Once you get in this position, wiggle them. This gets the inner muscles in your hand moving. Now, at first, you might not be able to go like this automatically. So just use a little bit of assistance with the other hand, just like that. This will increase your range of motion. Another good crossover is taking your second finger over your third finger, just like this, and then stretching out this way. With both hands. Now, at first, just go slow, go at your own pace. That's the main thing with all these exercises, just go at your own pace, just like that. Okay, now that our hands are warmed up, let's move on to the first set of exercises, the folds.
Folds.
One of the most natural positions our hands can assume is simply folding your hands. Put your hands together and fold them down. As you notice, my right thumb is on top. Some people may have their left thumb on top. That determines if you're right or left thumbed. Switch back and forth. All the way down. Go at your own pace, nice and slow. As with many of these exercises, I'll do them slow and then speed them up to show you what you should be working for. But at first, go slow. One of the most important points of this program is finger isolation. We're going to take the same exercise, simply do this one at a time. First, your first finger, second finger, third finger, and fourth finger. Now, I lead with my right finger on top. If you're left thumbed, you might feel more comfortable leading with your left finger on top. Back and forth. And with time, you should be able to develop speed. But go slow at first, all the way down. Now, let's try this two at a time. All the way down, nice and slow, making it very automatic. And that's what you should be striving eventually to work for. Let's try three at a time. These three, back and forth. A variation on the folds is putting all your fingers down, now extending one at a time. First finger, second, third, and fourth, and coming back up. First, go slow until it becomes more automatic. Or extending one pair of fingers at a time. This is very good for finger independence. Now that we've learned how to fold your hands in various ways, let's move on to the taps.